Michael Brown's mother, Leslie McSpadden, reacts to Officer Darren Wilson explaining why he shot and killed her son.
I gave myself another mental check. Can I shoot this guy? You know, can I legally? And the question I answered myself was, I have to. If I don't, he will kill me if he gets to me.
McSpadden says she doesn't believe a word of Wilson's story. But the grand jurors clearly did, and along with other evidence, decided not to indict him. McSpadden says no one from the city of Ferguson has reached out to her after her son's shooting. She says that's why she and her current husband chose to listen to the announcement of the grand jury decision among the protesters outside the police department.
I felt the need to do that because, one, they never addressed us, and two, you've heard our pleas and our cries for everything to go the way it should be. And then third of all, we heard this, and it was just like I had been shot, like you shooting me now. Just no respect, no sympathy, nothing. And so my emotions were raging, and I had to go up there just to let them know, you just really don't care, do you? And why don't you care? This could be your child. This could be anybody's child.
She reacted with sorrow. Her husband responded with anger. Lewis Head has been accused by some in the public of inciting the riots with those words.
His emotions were taking over him just like mine. He just spoke out of anger. It's one thing to speak and it's a different thing to act. He did not act. He just spoke out of anger. I'm a grieving mother. That's my husband. He's been around Michael at least 4 years. So he's grown to love him, not as much as I do, but he's grown to love him like he loves his own children. So when you're that hurt and the system has did you this wrong, you may say some things as well. We've all spoke out of anger before.
So you can certainly hear the sadness and the sorrow that the Brown family feels. I do want to talk to you a little bit about the frustration and sorrow that the folks here in Ferguson feel who own businesses, the folks in residents who live here, and the fact that the National Guard is still here. They are still here at the PD. Let me give you a little look about what's going on. The National Guard members out in a much smaller force today because I want to show you why. Before, there were quite a few more troops. Normally, we've got a fair number of people who are out protesting. Today, we're not seeing that. What we're seeing is just a couple of people. Mostly, it's a bus fare. Mostly, it's just media who's standing here. But for days, for more than 100 days, there have been people out here every single night. This is the first night we haven't seen any sort of big crowds.